BBC introducing
in Hereford and Worcester.
So good afternoon then, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Copgut Elm in Droitwich Spa, of course all part of the festival. This next act who I'm going to introduce has been writing music for 15 to 20 years now. She's from Hereford, she runs her own cleaning business, and music really is a weekend job. And when it isn't a weekend job, she's been training for 4 years as a boxer and now teaches children. So don't offend her, otherwise you're going to be walking out with a black eye. Put your hands together for Natalie Hall.
This is Remote Control. I think of a year ago when you couldn't put me down. I was your favorite and you always wanted me around. Now I'm just torn pieces, my heart is on the ground. I can't see because my face has been put down. Doesn't matter if I'm switched on. I can't see because my eyes have been pulled out. I can't scream because I don't have a mouth. All I want is to be taken out. I'm too old and daddy will be left out. Doesn't matter if I'm switched on. Once so new, forgotten so soon. Now I'm broken, can no longer trust you. And this is it, I'm the fool. You won't be there to take me home. Doesn't matter if I'm switched on. Okay, the next song that we're going to do for you is Seasick. Rolling in reverse, never knowing the meaning. trying to run away from this curse. You will stand alone and fight. Don't be scared to die. You will tip your own boat over, swim in the sea, looking for your four-leaf clover. You only find three. You will tip your own boat over, swim in the sea.
From Natalie Hall live at the Copcut Elm as part of the Droitwich Music Festival, and she's with me now. Natalie, hello.
Hello.
You're looking very, very summery today. You've got a beautiful floral garland, the necklace, the maxi dress, loving it, and it's sunny today, which is amazing.
Oh, thanks so much. Just dressing for the weather.
Yeah, and your music today is quite uplifting, acoustic, stripped back. How do you think it went?
Oh, I was really pleased. So.
You've been singing for a long time now, haven't you?
15, 20 years.
And what have the highlights been over that time during your singing career?
I guess just writing my own music and performing it in places like this, you know, that's a great achievement for me.
What's been the standout gig or festival that you've played?
I've done a few shows around Herefordshire when they have boxing shows on, so I've got in the ring when there's been about 600-700 people. And
I've heard you're a properly trained up boxer as well. What a dark horse.
Yeah. Well, I do it for fun, really, but it's just turned into something a bit more.
Where did the love for boxing come from?
Well, I just needed something to get fit, really. I was getting quite lazy and getting a bit older, so I just thought that boxing would be a good way to keep fit, and it just turned into a love then.
You keep your bandmates in shape as well if they step
out.
Why did you play that corner?
I know, I'm terrible.
Is music it the day job or what's your day job?
Oh, I've got a little cleaning business that I run in the daytime. Right. And then pretend to be a big singer on the weekend. So it's sort of just a nice balance, really.
And that's a long-term aim for you, your music?
Oh, no, if something happened, I'd definitely jump at the music scene. It's not as easy as that, so I just do it where I can.
Your song, The Journey, got loads of attention from MTV, didn't it? Oh. Tell us about that.
Quite odd. That was quite a few years ago now. They used it for one of their shows.
Did you just get a phone call one day saying, yeah. Oh, hi, Natalie, we're going to use one of your songs?
Yeah, pretty much. That was it.
Bless you. Thanks for coming to play for us. Cheers, Natalie.
Oh, thanks so much.
BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester.
With Andrew Marston.
Be part of it.
Now I face another wall. Don't know if I can climb it. Don't know if I have the strength to fight it. Please, Lord, help me out. I'm in a jam, I don't see a way out. Told you we're nothing, you start to believe. And fear is something that's stopping me achieve. Please, Lord, help me out. I've energy and I don't see you way out. All I need is just a little guidance.
Okay, this is going to be my last song. Thanks very much. This is called Happy Song. I'm sure you've heard these chords before. And I'm sure you hear them many more. But I wanted to write a happy song. 'Cause I've been told that my singing sounds down. I
sorry about my voice. But I've been living in a real bad way. Living in a bad way. I think it could be divine. Or maybe it's my smoky days.
Absolutely amazing. The singer, she's gorgeous.
What's the best gig you've ever been to?
I haven't really been to anything that recently, but when I was younger, I went to Bon Jovi. That was pretty good.
Where was that?
I can't remember where it was. I was only young. My mom's obsessed with and Boy George, so...
You got dragged along.
Dragged along to that one. The only boy, you see.
What do you think of Natalie Hall from Hereford?
Yeah, she's really good looking, and she's probably getting really far in life. She's better than the other singers who just go for it for fame.
What do you think?
Taylor Swift, Lily Allen, people like that.
And I thought she was really, really good, and she was really confident, and I really liked her songs. Oh, I really listen to a bit of everything. I'm really, really into my music, so just whatever I'm in the mood for.
Yeah. And what's the best gig or festival you've been to?
Last year I went for the Global Gathering. That was just amazing.
Who did you see there? Who's your favourite?
There was loads of quite famous DJs, like Hardwell. And I saw a band called Infected Mushroom, who I really, really like.
What do you think makes a good gig or a good festival or a good DJ set?
It's difficult to put your finger on it, but I think just the energy and the atmosphere in the actual place has to be good. But they also have to obviously play well and be original and a bit different. If you're walking around a festival and there's loads of bands that are just really samey, you're just going to walk straight past them and not pay any attention. So you want something to grab you and be really, really cool.
Can you describe, for the people who weren't here today but are hearing this on the radio, what the setup looks like for Natalie Hall? Like, what could you see when she was performing?
Well, she had two acoustic guitarists either side of her. She was just in the middle.
Thanks very much.
Thanks.
Listen to the best interviews online.
bbc.co.uk/Hereford
and Worcester/introducing.